Hello students, in the previous class we have seen how to add mixed numbers. So here we are going to learn how to subtract mixed numbers. So we are going to follow these steps. Step 1, we will convert the mixed number into improper, then subtract the improper fraction, express it in simplest form. If still your answer is improper, change it back to a mixed number. Let's have a look at the first example. The mixed number is 3 1 upon 2. I need to convert this into a improper fraction. So the denominator 2 will remain same. To get the numerator, what you have to do here is you multiply 3 and 2, and that product you add 1. So I need to do 3 times 2 plus 1. So 3 times 2 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7. So I get the answer 7 by 2. The second mixed number 1 3/5, denominator is 5. So I'll write here 5. To get the numerator, you need to multiply 1 and 5 and add 3. So 1 times 5 plus 3. So I'll get here 8 over 5. Now these two fractions are unlike fractions, so you cannot combine them. So what we have to do is you need to find the LCM of the denominator. So let's find the LCM of 2 and 5. Now I'll always start with the multiple of the big number. 5 1 times is 5. I'll check if this 5 is a multiple of 2. It is not. So in that case I'll go for the next multiple of 5. 5 2 times is 10. Is 10 a multiple of 2? Yes. So 10 is my LCM, my least common multiple. So I need 10 as the denominator of both the fraction. So the first fraction denominator is 2, so I need 10, so I multiply by 5, so I have to multiply the numerator also by 5. I need 10 here, so I multiply by 2, so the numerator also I'll multiply by 2. Now let's simplify it. 7 times 5 gives me 35 over 10 minus 8 times 2 is 16 over 10. Now since they are like fractions, I can subtract the numerators. Denominator stays the same. 35 minus 16 gives me 19. Now this fraction is in simplest form. You cannot reduce it further. But it is an improper fraction, so we need to express this as a mixed number. So from 19, I can take 10 only one time. So if you take away 10, you're left with 9, and the denominator 10 will come here as it is. So this is how you subtract and simplify your answer. Let's have a look at one more example. Now, I have 5 3/4 and 2 1 over 8. So, the denominator 4 will be same. To get the numerator, I'll multiply 5 and 4 and add 3. So, 5 times 4 is 20 plus 3 is 23. Minus, I have here 8, so my denominator will be 8. To get the numerator, 8 times 2, you will multiply these two numbers and add the numerator. 8 times 2 is 16, 16 plus 1 is 17 over 8. Now, again, the denominators are not same. It means they are unlike fractions. So, we need to find the LCM of 4 and 8. So, always start with the multiple of the big number. 8, 1 times is 8. Is 8 a multiple of 4? Yes. So, my LCM is 8. Now, the second denominator is already 8, so you don't need to change anything here. The first one, I have 4, I need 8, so I'll multiply by 2, I'll multiply the numerator also by 2. So, 23 times 2 gives me 46 over 8 minus 17 over 8. Now, I have like fractions, so I'll simply subtract. So, the denominator will be 8, 46 minus 17 will give me 29 over 8. Now, let's see if we can reduce it further. It is not possible. And again, my answer is a improper fraction. So, I'll express it as a mixed number. So, from 29, how many times can we take 8? So, I can take 8 3 times because 8 3 times is 24 and 8 4 times is 32. So, not possible. So, I can take 8 from 29 3 times. So, 8 3 times is 24. When I take away 24, I am left with 5. So, I write the remainder here 5 and 8 as it is. So, this is my final answer. That's it.